What's up, everyone? Bridget from Riverside here, and let's walk you through Riverside's dashboard. Riverside's dashboard consists of four main components. The main dashboard, which will direct you to where you want to go. The studio, where you will record all of your content. The recording page, which shows all of the recordings done in a particular studio. And the recording take page, which gives you a variety of tools to create content from each individual recording. Once you are in Riverside's main dashboard, you will have access to all studios. You can also create a new one. You can change the layout based on your personal preference by clicking List View or Grid View. Underneath each studio, you have the option to go into the studio, view all recordings, and invite people. To invite guests to your show, click Invite People. You will then be given a shareable link and you can send them an email directly through Riverside. By clicking the gear icon, you can check and update settings. If you want to read through what each of these settings means individually, feel free to pause the screen or head to the collection of studio support articles linked in the description. Next, you can adjust the specifics of your recording. Here, you can change things like video recording quality, your audio sample rate, and you can decide if the studio will default to Riverside's noise suppression tool, which removes any background noise like air conditioning and traffic. You can then set up your studio to stream live on various platforms. Check out our YouTube video specifically on live streaming, linked above and in the description. This is the Riverside Studio, where you will record all of your content. During the recording, you can check all of the guests' audio levels. You can add in live intros, outros, music, and sound effects. If you want a full walkthrough of the Riverside Studio, watch the walkthrough linked above and in the description. Once you've recorded all of your content in the studio, you can access your recordings on the Studio Recordings page. From the main dashboard, click View All Recordings. This is your studio recordings page, where you'll see thumbnails for each recording session that has happened in that studio. To share all of your studio's recordings with someone else, click the link button at the top. Now, let's click on a specific recording. This is where all of your content lives. Riverside makes it easy to create a whole bunch of content from your one-time recording. Here you can see the upload status of all participants. You can preview the full recording, but it's important to note that the quality of the recording that you see here is not the quality of the final exported video. At this point, you will see any clips that you marked during your recording. For more information on clips, watch our clips walkthrough linked above and in the description. You will also see various snapshots from the recording that you can share directly on social media platforms and download for future use. You can download separate audio and video tracks for each track in the session. For video, we recommend downloading the constant frame rate MP4 to ensure that audio and video are synced up properly. To get a transcription of your recording, click on the three dots at the top of the page. This will be available to download after a few minutes. Here, you will also see the option to download backups and internet recordings. To save time in post-production, you can use the editor tool. This tool will allow you to merge tracks and export the final recording, create clips from your long-form content, and resize these clips to different aspect ratios to share on various social media platforms. For a more detailed walkthrough of the editor tool, click the card at the top of the screen to watch our editor tutorial. There you have it, the Riverside dashboard. Riverside is here to help you create more content and reach more people all from just one recording. For more information and for additional help, head to riverside.fm/support. Thanks for watching this walkthrough. Make sure to let us know how you'll be using Riverside in the comments. And of course, subscribe to our page and follow us on social media for more tips and tricks on how you can use Riverside for all things podcasting and beyond.